Hello everyone, I'm Alexandre Nora, a PhD student of INSARN in France, working with Carole Desnos, Michael Dardaillon and Jean-François Nézan. In just 5 minutes, I will present you our paper entitled A Fast Heuristic to Pipeline SDF Graphs. First, what is pipelining? It is an optimization to increase the throughput of an application. It adds extra buffered data, called delays, on specific locations of the application task graph, called graph cuts. Depending on the task graph, there might be a tremendous amount of such graph cuts. Now, what are synchronous data flow graphs? They are a generalization of task graphs annotated with fixed amount of data exchange. It implies that each task may be executed multiple times in order to process all data sent by the preceding tasks. I will not enter into the details of SDF graphs. In our heuristic, we only use the fact that each task may be executed multiple times inside a single execution of the application. Let's see a small example. With the task graph on the left, without any delay, we obtain the schedule presented on the right. Initiation interval is 3 time unit, which gives a speedup equal to 1.33 relatively to the sequential time. The schedule is repeated indefinitely, here 2 times. Now, if you add delays on the graph cut located after the task beta, the dependencies to task gamma and delta are delayed until the next scheduled iteration, and the initiation interval is reduced to 2 time units, giving a speedup equal to 2. Note that to be valid, a graph cut cannot cross cycles of the graph. To compute automatically such graph cuts where to add delays, we need 3 inputs. First, an SDF graph with estimated execution times of its tasks. Then, the number of processing elements in the target architecture. And finally, the maximum number of graph cuts that the user wants. The number of graph cuts corresponds to the number of pipeline stages, minus 1. 2 parameters are used for this setting. 1 to select the amount of cuts balanced by workload, and the other to select the best cuts among the preselected ones. As an output, our heuristic simply returns the input SDF graph, with delays added on the selected graph cuts. To do so, the heuristic orders the task of the graph according to as soon as possible and as late as possible topological orderings. These 2 orderings give a small subset of all valid graph cuts. Then, these graph cuts are used to split the graph in consecutive sections of equivalent workload. In the following example, we perform the cut after the task beta according to as soon as possible ordering. Compared to the previous example, slide 2, which uses as late as possible ordering, it saves 1 delay between alpha and delta, and thus it reduces the memory footprint. Our heuristic is highly scalable, since it only requires a few graph traversals. Also, the number of selected cuts is limited by the graph diameter. We have implemented our heuristic in the Prism open source framework. We have used the Streamint benchmark and a few of our own applications to evaluate it. The list scheduler measures the speedup. Here is a small excerpt of our results, for the application having numerous possible graph cuts. It is clearly not possible to test and schedule each of them in a reasonable time. On the right, the last 2 columns give the speedup without any cut, and then with 3 cuts selected by our heuristic. For channel vocoder and filter bank applications, the speedup increases by a factor 3. Our heuristic only takes a few milliseconds to compute the best graph cuts. Moreover, for applications where the total number of cuts is small enough, we have compared the efficiency of our graph cuts with all of them, and in average, our cuts give a better speedup than 90% of all possible cuts. Finally, we have provided a scalable and efficient heuristic to pipeline SDF graphs as well as regular task graphs. Our heuristic is a standalone optimization, it does not involve any scheduling process. However, some of our experiments have shown that the amount of memory required to execute the application may dramatically increase due to the delays. Thus, future work is to reduce the amount of added delays by breaking data dependencies of only a subset of the multiple task executions. Also, it would be good to mix our heuristic with retiming algorithms, especially to benefit from delays located on cycles. It's the end of this presentation, so if you have any questions, please contact me on the following email address. Goodbye!